Hi, my name is Elizabeth Russell, and I am a master's student in the Animal Welfare Program. And today I'll be presenting on some of my master's research. So the calf rearing phase has received considerable attention with a large body of research that has really focused on the best practices to wean calves. However, there's quite a bit of variation in management practices on farm, and little is known about how dairy producers view calf rearing. We sought to investigate the attitudes and perceptions of dairy producers in Western Canada towards calf rearing with a focus on calf weaning. We approached this study with two main objectives. The first being to explore producer views and perceptions regarding heifer rearing in general and calf weaning in particular. And two, to understand how producers characterize weaning success. To best approach these objectives, we interviewed a total of 18 dairy producers from across Western Canada. The majority of participants were identified as being either the owner or manager of the farm, and the remaining were identified as a primary calf caretaker. Four main themes were identified. The first being reliance on calf-based indicators. The second being management and personal experiences. The third, perceived environmental influences. And four, integration of external farm support. And what I'm going to do today is I'm going to walk you through a bit of these themes with our word cloud shown here. This word cloud gives a nice glimpse into the common words used by participants in the study. The larger the word you see, the more often the words was mentioned. We found that participants relied on calf-based indicators. These are calf-based measurements such as feeding behavior, vocalizations, social behavior such as learning and playing. And participants also noted the body growth and calf health as being additional areas of focus. Management practices and personal experiences were also identified as being important markers of success and sometimes challenges. Participants mentioned the importance of keeping practices consistent and easy, along with paying attention to detail. Participants also know the influence of environmental factors, such as barns and housing style, along with the use of equipment like automatic milk feeding systems and pasteurizers. Finally, participants highlighted the influence of external farm support for the farm. This was seen by their relationship with their veterinarians, including the enrollment in a calf monitoring programs through the veterinary clinics, as well as the influence of peers and conferences. In conclusion, our findings help to contribute to understanding how calves are reared on farms and will best help to inform future experimental studies as well as on-farm work to better understand best management practices for calf rearing. Thank you.